The next thing that I want to touch upon is what thing do we use this money in? Really, why? So around 11,000 years back, that is in 9,000 BC, the first thing that society or people started using as money was day-to-day utilities or commodities like grain or cattle or beads or seashells, whatever was available in nature but was still scarce. So you would not use rocks or sand because there was abundance of it. It had to be precious. It had to be a little rare. But this kind of money, these commodities were difficult to use as money. They had problems with durability. Grain could get spoiled, cattle could die. There goes your money. It had problems with portability. It was difficult to move it from one place to the other, you know, drag your cow along when you have to pay someone. It had problems with divisibility. I mean, imagine if your tribe is accepting money, which is cattle, and you want to make a small transaction, then you can understand the challenges. Then after about 5,000 years, that is around 4,000 BC, precious metals started being used. And that happened when different tribes wanted to kind of transact with each other, and suddenly everybody started accepting precious metals, you know, because one tribe would use beads and the other one would use cattle, and then precious metals emerged as this global currency. And that happened because, of course, precious metals were rare, but it also happened because precious metals were better than the previous thing that society was using as money, like grain or cattle. They were more durable, more easily portable, and more divisible, more easily divisible. You could just heat up precious metal, liquefy it, break it into parts, so you could use it for smaller transactions. Then just 1,000 years back, paper money was born. Now this happened when people who had gold started depositing their precious metal, their gold, with goldsmiths, mainly to prevent theft at home. And the goldsmiths became bankers and they started issuing paper receipts, you know, in exchange of deposit as a proof. And that's how currency note was born. And over a period of time, what happened was, rather than physically exchanging gold, people started exchanging these paper receipts because they found it a lot more convenient. You know, just go back to the goldsmith, get your gold, then pay someone, just give the paper receipt, you know, and that person would accept it. In fact, before 1918, you know, this is just less than 100 years back, I'm sure not many of you know that, there were more than 5,000 different banknotes in circulation in the US alone. If you look closely, each US dollar bill was issued by a different bank. And you could actually take one of these currency notes back to the issuing bank and exchange it for a fixed amount of precious metal like silver or gold. This kind of money that people were using before 1918 were, as experts call, backed by the gold standard. Fast forward to what we currently use as money. What happened over the last 100 years, okay, just 100 years, that country after country, nation after nation, exited the gold standard. The money that we now use is, as experts call, fiat money. And if you look up the word fiat in dictionary, fiat means something that has no intrinsic value. The only reason it has value is because some central authority says so, and we as a society accept that. So contrary to popular belief, the current thing that we use as money is fiat money, not backed by the gold standard, and is less than 100 years old. Thank you.